subscribing to the channel and returning each and every time I put a video out. So it's a lot of things going on in the world, right? And you're asking yourself, well, I'm just new to this. I'm just starting. I don't know what to get. I don't know where to start. We about to go into this Dollar Tree and we gonna figure out where we need to start and what we need to do. But you need to start with your basics, like your protein, get your dairy, get your grains, get your life. How about that? Okay. And in prepping, you're gonna be getting your life. It's gonna be a little costly, so take your time. Don't break the bank all in one go, okay? Because you still got bills to pay. Now, them bills still going to be rolling in. It don't matter what's going on in the world, but you're going to get that light bill, that water bill, that cable bill, that phone bill. You're going to get it all, honey. So make sure you get a little bit at a time if you only have limited money. If you got a lot of money to blow, the best place to blow it is on your preps, okay? Not going off and going to Disneyland and Disney World. Nothing wrong with it. I wish I could go, but I can't, okay? So I do what my money can afford. And right now, we about to go in this Dollar Tree, and we're going to find about 10 things that you can get today, okay, to start your preps and get you on your way. Now, mind you, you might be able to find these things a little bit cheaper if you go to Walmart and some other stores, but not everybody like going to Walmart. So wherever you go, get your deals, use your little card, let them swipe and get the store credit, whatever you got to do to get that sale. And so again, I want to say welcome to the channel. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I appreciate each of you for being here, and you got the right one, baby. What's that slogan for? Let me know in the comments if you remember. I don't know. I might have mixed it up. But anyway, y'all, I just love you guys, and I want you guys to succeed in whatever it is you're doing, whether it's growing your garden, stocking your home up with canned goods, dry goods, or whatever you're doing. I want you to be successful in doing it. And if I can help, I will. So help each other out in the comments, because it's a lot of you that know more than me, okay? And y'all be helping me in the comments. I see you. I see you. Now, you know I have a hard time being quiet sometimes when I'm doing these videos, but I need to let you know, this is the same Dollar Tree that I would normally go in, that there was nothing in there, boxes everywhere, blah, blah, blah. Y'all, I ain't been here in over a month, maybe two. And some of y'all know, because y'all shop the same store, because I've run into you. This store looked okay. I'm just going to say okay. I'm not going to say good, okay? So let's go over some stuff that we need to get. I'm going to tell you right now, it's more than 10 things that I'm doing right here in this video. So I want to apologize for those who say, you know, I'm putting stuff in the title, but I'm not doing it. Bump that. I'm giving you all I can give you. So we've talked about gardening. And like my girl Carter Eat says, get there, get there, get there. Y'all need to get this stuff, whether you get it from here or not, and start growing your own food. The cost is still going up. Y'all, it's time to send these little precious children back off to school. So get your school supplies. Whether you get them from here, get them somewhere else, just go ahead and get them now. Y'all know I've already done a video saying school supplies might be coming in a little slow, so get them where you can. Storage containers is another good thing to have. Not for one, you need organization in your life. Lord knows I need organization in my pantry. And also, you can use these to plant in. Next, we have solar lights. I've shown you how you can use these solar lights in your house. Leave them out all day, bring them in at the end of the day, especially when the power goes out with these pop-up storms. So either in one of my other videos that you've already seen or one that you're about to see, I'm gonna tell you now, get some stuff for these kids. It's too hot for them to be out this door. Sometimes you gotta keep them busy. You gotta keep them busy, whether it's painting, coloring, or whatever. Here goes some more storage bins they had in a different area. You can use them as a caddy for your cleaning supplies, for your kids' stuff, just whatever you want to use it for. Grab you a few of those and get busy. You can take those bins I just showed you, take some of these cleaning supplies, store them under your shelves, under your sink. That way you have a little more organization. Y'all don't want to see up under my sink. I'm saying it, but I need to do it myself. By chance you have pets, don't forget your pets, because they don't forget you. They love you unconditionally, even when others are, you know, just rotten to you. Also, make sure you have candles, whether it's scented or unscented. It doesn't matter. You need light when the power goes out, or you just want to set the mood. You're stocking up, you want to have quality items in your preps. Now, you might not want the duct tape from the Dollar Tree, but guess what? I've gotten the duct tape, but I didn't use it for anything that was way, way important. But it's good to have a backup so you have your good stuff for the more important things. Another great item to add is clothespins, because if your power goes out, you got to wash by hand. You want to be able to hang stuff out. So get your clothespins, get the even the little cord that you can tie to a tree or whatever you can tie it to, so you can use that to hang, like back in the day when my mama used to do it. You know what I'm saying? I didn't like the smell of the clothes, you know, hanging out there in the air, but it's something to do. Now, I want to apologize in advance for this next picture, but I took it sideways, but it is a container collapsible. You can grow in these. I grew strawberries in mine last year, and it was just fine. Now, I don't know why they didn't have this item over with the cleaning supplies, but they had it up front. And I know why, though. I kind of do know why. This stuff is awesome. Not just the name, but this stuff is awesome. It really works. So if you're just starting prepping, getting your soaps, your shampoos, your conditioners, your lotions, all those things, Dollar Tree has come up with the brands that they have. And some of it is better than what you find in the store at a reasonable price. So I would say, please stock up on those items. Now, you see some empty shelves here. They did have a few throughout the store here and there. This is the baby item. Don't forget your babies. Now, over here, we have your refrigerator section. Y'all, it didn't look that great, so that's why I didn't say they were great. They were good. Don't forget your feminine products. You know your tampons are running short, so are your pads gonna start running short as well, because there's a shortage on cotton. When it comes to Q-tips, cotton balls, all of those are good things to add to your preps, because you can use those along with Vaseline to start a fire. When you're starting a stockpile, you want to think ahead to the future. What might happen in the future? Will I hurt my back? Will I hurt my foot? Will I have a rash? Will I have whatever going on with me? You want to have those things in your stockpile and not have to run out to the store, because guess what? That store might not be open, or that store might not have it now. Now, here's where it gets tricky. The next thing you need to be getting is pain medication, cold medication, flu medication. Their section looked horrible in here, I will agree. But those are things you need to be adding to your stockpile. Right now, you're probably saying, well, Tommy or Miss Bites, whatever y'all call me, why you put these in here? Well, some people find these a necessity. And if you do, go ahead and grab you some. I don't wear eyelashes. I have no need for them. Mine are thick. And also, I can't eat them. I can't. It's not an Oreo. I don't know what it is. Well, I didn't just come on this aisle for you guys to remind you to get your oral health and hygiene products. But yes, you do need to add those to your stockpile. Why? Because you don't want to have that ache and pain of a toothache because you weren't caring for your teeth. And nobody wants to smell funky breath when the power goes out in the heat of summer in 108 degrees. Your body gonna smell and your mouth too? No, we not doing that today, sis. Bruh. Okay, but I was over here because my son needed some toothbrushes because he wanted to use some to clean his fish tank. Some of you guys may be new to my channel. So I'm married. I have 4 kids. I have 2 that are not my husband's kids, and they are older kids, and I have grandkids, 5 of them. Okay. So my older kids, they know about these magic towels because I used to buy them all the time when we would go on trips to the beach or whatever. You know, that's when you could afford gas, or you could afford to have fun with your kids and it not hurt you later and you cry at night about it. These things are good to add in your to-go bags or whatever bag, and plus it's fun for the kids. Now, I'm probably gonna get a lot of flack for this, but let's talk mask. Okay, they got these masks in here. It's 5 of them in here for $1.25. get your kids some masks. The youngin's about to go back to school. We don't know what's gonna happen when they go back to school, whether they're gonna have mask mandates or no mask mandates, because we don't know what the numbers are gonna look like in a few weeks, because the numbers are still ticking up. So don't come at me in the comments, because I'm just telling you to prepare ahead of time. And plus, they have other strands and variants out here that is expected to hit come fall and winter. So cover your kids' health, okay? Because don't nobody care about them but you and your immediate family. You know, I love the kids, but I'm saying, when I say other people, I mean the government, okay? Now, I warned y'all it's gonna be more than 10 things in here, so you know, leave me a 1 if you liking what I'm doing. You know, But if you don't, you don't. Anyway, right here, we talking about comfort foods. Cookies, chips, whatever your comfort food is, chocolate. Get it if you need it. If you going to be an angry person, please get those items. Don't nobody want to hear you complain about you need a Snicker bar because you ain't going nowhere. Don't nobody want to hear any of that. So get what you need. Get your coffee. Get whatever it is you need. Go ahead and get it now because it may be short come fall and winter. Some like it hot, some like it not. If you like sriracha, you better go ahead on and get it because there is a shortage of sriracha. There is an olive shortage. It might not be nationwide, but there is one. Now, this area over here was starting to get a little iffy. Get your pastas and your grains, your rice, and all that good stuff. But over here, you know, they was front facing like a mother. And make sure you get your canned meat. Y'all, I can't say it enough. Meat is going up. Whether it's chicken or cattle or whatever it is you're eating, meat is going up. Get you these little snack things. I have one right here because I'm about to pop it and eat it because I didn't bring any food and I don't want to eat out. Also, if you're growing or you're not growing, get you some canned fruit, canned vegetables. You need to have backups for your backups and for your backups. It's nothing like needing a battery and not having a battery, whether it's for your remote, for your flashlight, for your for whatever it is you need it for. Get your batteries and get ready for whatever's gonna happen. Y'all know I can't see to read anything without my glasses, but I have extras. So if you don't, this is a good place or any place to get you an extra set of reading glasses. Honestly, y'all, it's too hot to cook inside. It's too hot to cook outside, but I'd rather cook outside and have me some of these pans right here that I can use than to put that heat in my house. Remember this song? I like bread and butter. I like toast and jam. I like the taste of... Anyway, y'all, get your bread. You can freeze your bread. It defrosts just fine. Doesn't take long at all. Whether it's healthy or not, it's still a snack. It's still something for your kids to eat on and make them feel good in the middle of a crisis. Every time I see this next item, I think of Wilona from Good Times, Koofy Coffee, when she was drinking all that coffee because she really needed to stay away. Add your seasonings and your baking items to your stock list because nobody wants bland food. Well, some people do, but not everybody. Now, I'm not saying you got to get toilet paper from the Dollar Tree. I know some of y'all, but they have some brands in here that regular stores have as well. So get what you can find and make it happen. Paper plates and cups and bowls and spoons, y'all, put that in your stockpile because you want to save all the water you can when it comes to washing dishes. These containers I had to get for my son, I just thought I'd throw them in there, but these are great containers to store your extra food in or your produce from your garden in. But of course, kids think different from their parents. He's trying to store his gecko food in it and talking about he want a snake, and my husband told him, why would you get an animal that can kill you? We're not doing that in here, sir. Get that out your brain. The only animal that's coming up in here is the animals that we are going to feed, and they're going to feed us back in return. But it's not going to be anything up in here that's going to be feeding on us. Get extra of your cleaning supplies, especially your toiletries and your gloves and all of those things. Add your Ziploc bags to it. And don't forget your aluminum foil, because that is going to come in handy, as well as your trash bags to discard of anything you don't want. So this pan right here is for you to wash in. But guess what? You can grow in this as well. Just drill some holes in the bottom and around the sides. Fill it with soil, put your seeds in it, water it, and watch it grow. Last but not least, and it should have been over there with the medications, make sure you get you some alcohol. Make sure you get your cold medicines, your hydrogen peroxide, whatever you might need down the road for aches and pains. Because, you know, you can't predict what's going to happen, okay? But what you can do is prepare the best you can. So prep today so you are prepared for tomorrow. And I'll see you guys in the next video. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel, because we would love to have you here on Tommy Bice Homestead.